Hi, welcome to Rita's Kitchen. Today we're going to be fixing homemade vegetable soup. First I use a chuck roast, and I like to cook mine in a pressure cooker. You can cook it in a slow cooker or just on top of the stove, anything that you're comfortable with. But I prefer the pressure cooker. That's just what I'm used to. And after it's cooked and the pressure goes down, we'll remove the meat. Place it on a plate so we can dice it up and get rid of all the fat. Okay, I'll cut the meat up and I'll discard of all the fat parts. And I like to cut it up in nice small chunks, and you can see this is really tender. It's just falling apart. That's another reason I like to use the pressure cooker. This is really tender meat. I like to pre-em because Fred doesn't like chunks of tomatoes in his food. So I'll pre these. Just make a nice sauce out of it. Still have all the flavor. And it just takes a couple of seconds. I should do it. And we'll just pour this right into the broth. There we go. Now we'll go ahead and add our potatoes, corn, onions, cabbage, previously dices it, but I like to use about three large potatoes, about this size, one large carrot, a nice big fresh onion, and probably about a cup of cabbage. Now you don't have to put the cabbage in, but I just use whatever vegetables I have on hand. And I really like to make homemade vegetable soup at the end of the season after the garden's about finished and get all the fresh vegetables out of the garden. That's when it's the best. And my potatoes, my carrots, which I've previously diced, a cup, maybe a little more if you like cabbage, gives it a nice flavor, and one large onion. Give that a stir. Get rid of this. We're corn lovers, so I always like to put a can of whole kernel corn in. And for crunch, I like to use a can of water chestnuts. Drained, of course. This is really a simple thing to make, and you can get it ready in the morning and let it simmer all day long. Kitchen smells great and you have a great meal. Water chestnuts. And our corn. I like to drain the corn. There you go. I always use one bag of frozen mixed vegetables. I just do this because it's just so much more convenient than chopping a lot of different ones up. Just put the whole bag in there. Give it a stir or two. Now I'm going to turn this up so it gets warm, and then we'll turn it back on the simmer. Here, I'll add about a teaspoon of pepper and a couple teaspoons of salt. And just for a kick, I'll put about a tablespoon of hot sauce in there. That'll really liven it up. let that get warm, then we'll turn it over to simmer. We'll let it simmer for the rest of the day and have a wonderful supper. This is really nice coupled with homemade sourdough bread or a toasted cheese sandwich. Okay, I like to use one small chuck roast, and again, I use a pressure cooker just because it's time-saving technique, and I'm very comfortable with it. I use about 3 potatoes, diced small, 1 carrot. I use 1 large onion, about a cup of diced cabbage because we like cabbage, a can of water chestnuts sliced, and a can of whole kernel corn, and I use 1 bag of frozen mixed vegetables. I use 2 cans of tomatoes, but I also puree those just because Fred doesn't like the taste of the tomato in his mouth. And that's all there is to it, salt and pepper. Usually 2 teaspoons of salt, a teaspoon of pepper, and for a kick, I use about a tablespoon of hot sauce. And that's all there is to it, and we'll just let it cook till it gets finished.